Okay, so for today's video, we're going to take a quick look at dividing integers. The approach we're going to take with these questions is by using short division, or something you may have heard referred to as the bus stop method. So for this first question, I'm going to set it up like this. I've got 161 divided by 7. So first of all, we see how many 7s go into 1. So we can't fit any 7s into 1, so we put a 0 on the top. And then we carry over that 1 onto the next number, so we put it in front of the 6 there. So now we've got 16, so how many 7s fit into 16? Well, that would be 2, because 7 times 2 is 14, and that would leave us with a remainder of 2. So that remainder we carry over to the next number and put it in front. So I'd have that there. And then finally we look at how many 7s this time can fit into 21, and that would be 3. So for this example, 161 divided by 7 is actually 23. Okay, we've got some more questions now to practice this method. Feel free to pause the video here and we'll go through the answers in just a few seconds. Okay, for this first question, I have 438 divided by 3. So we go along, how many 3s fit into 4? Well, that'd be 1, and that'd leave us with a remainder of 1. We then see how many 3s fit into 13? Well, that'd be 4, because 3 times 4 is 12, with a remainder of 1 again, so that would go there. And then finally, how many 3s fit into 18? Well, we'd have 6, because 3 times 6 is 18. So our final answer to this one would be 146. Okay, moving on, we have 1024 divided by 4. So to begin with, we see how many 4s fit into 1? Well, 0, so we carry that 1 over to the next number. We then see how many 4s will fit into 10. Well, that'll be 2, because 4 times 2 is 8. That leaves us with a remainder of 2, so that carries over. We then see how many 4s fit into 22. Well, that'll be 5, because 4 times 5 is 20, with a remainder of 2, so we carry that over. And then finally, how many 4s fit into 24? That'd be 6. So our final answer to this question would be 256. Moving on to this next question, we have 870. Divided by 6. So how many 6s fit into 8? Well, that'll be 1 with a remainder of 2. We then do how many 6s fit into 27? Well, that'll be 4, because 6 times 4 is 24. That leaves us with a remainder of 3. And then finally, 6s into 30 go 5 times. So our final answer here would be 145. And then for this question, we have 2286 divided by 9. Well, how many 9s fit into 2? That's 0, so we carry the 2 over. So then 9s into 22, that would be 2, because 9 times 2 is 18, which leaves us with a remainder of 4, so that would go there. We then do 9s into 48, well, that would be 5, because 9 times 5 is 45, that leaves us with a remainder of 3. And then finally, 9s into 36 would be 4. So our answer to this one would be 254. So well done if you followed those solutions. So to finish off for today, we're going to take a look at a final few more questions. So just like before, feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the answers in just a few seconds. Okay, for this first question, we've got 3,795 divided by 11. So to begin with, how many 11s fit into 3? Well, that would be none, so 0, carry over the 3. We then do 11 into 37, so that would be 3, because 11 times 3 is 33, leaving us a remainder of 4. Then do 11s into 49, that would be 4, because 11 times 4 is 44, which would leave us with a remainder of 5. And then finally we can see 11s into 55 go exactly 5 times. So our answer to this question would be 345. And for our next question, we have 3,060 divided by 12. So again, 12s into 3 don't go, so then we carry over the 3. 12s into 30 go twice, because 12 times 2 is 24, that leaves us with a remainder of 6. We then do 12s into 66, well, that would go 5 times, because 12 times 5 is 60, that leaves us with a remainder of 6. And then finally, we have 12s into 60, which goes exactly 5 times. So our answer to this one would be 255. And for our very last question today, we have 13,000. 675 divided by 25. So to begin with, we have 25s into 1 don't go, so we carry the 1 over. 25s into 13 also don't go, so I'm going to carry that 13 over. So now I have how many 25s fit into 136? Well, that would be 5, because 25 times 5 is 125, which is going to leave me with a remainder of 11. So that goes there. We then see how many 25s will go into 117. That'll be 4, because 25 times 4 is 100, leaving me with a remainder of 17. And then finally, how many 25s fit into 175? Well, I know there's 4 of them in 100, there's 3 of them in 75, so 4 add 3 is 7. So our final answer to this question would actually be 547. So well done if you followed along, and that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any specific topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.